the cold is a great trainer. It's a great stress trainer because you're going to have a reaction for the first like 20 or 30 seconds that you're in there. It's cold, right? So yeah. You're going to have that reaction. But what we're actually working on is gathering your breath, gathering the control while you're in that situation. So then that situation isn't as stressful as it first was. So it's like a metaphor. The more you train that, the less normal stress affects you the way that it did before. What you're actually training is your body's ability to deal more optimally with the stress that you're experiencing in the moment.
I'm ready. All my line cooks can relate when they go into a walk-in freezer and get the meats. All the stress from grabbing that stuff.
Think it away, something like that.
Do you take fish oil supplements?
No, nothing.
Do you eat a lot of fish?
Yeah, yes, I like fish.
You like salmon?
Yeah.
Wim Hof. Wim is a... I've never met anyone like Wim. I don't even, he's just such a magnetic force. Wim is a force. I don't even know if like human comparables even exist. Yeah, I don't know. You know, he's the most magnetic person I've ever been around in my life. I've never met anyone like Wim. He is, he's probably like the truest person in terms of virtue, what he says and what he does that I've ever met in my life.
I'm Kathy.
I'm Michael.
And we live here.
Hey, you guys!
Yeah, so this is our home, and out of our home we facilitate different workshops and retreats and different classes and things like that. So that's our mission, and our goal is to continue to grow on the land and with the land and provide different classes and workshops and the health and wellness space.
We don't let them take our exhale, right? Our exhale, that's our source of power and control while we're in this. The more we activate it, the more we tune into it.
People know him as the Iceman, but there's this like specific kind of breathing technique that, you know, he does, where people are like, just do the breath, just do the breath. So the first time I did the breath, it blew me away in 3 minutes. I started hearing Wim everywhere. He was on Rhonda Patrick's podcast, same thing like in the Goggins space, David Goggins space, and then he was on Rogan and Tim Ferriss, we both love. And there are a lot of people that I really admire that were like, this dude is the thing, he's it.
You know, oftentimes things are like yoga, yogis or things like that, or like holistic kind of modalities of training and trainers. There's this like air of like passivity and like woo-woo and like everything, man. And that is not Wim at all. Like Wim is an alpha that goes straight for it.
We say often there are a lot of charlatans in the health and wellness game, you know, really wanted to make sure that the person that not only I was following, but ultimately that I wanted to lead other people to, was the real deal. Anyway, so we had an excavator come and take a look, and it's still, you know, it would still be pretty dope to have this.
Well, I guess they both had both, in my opinion, different backgrounds coming into the experience, you know, thinking about how they each have kind of like reflected, and I mean, I've heard more.
I had some moments where I'm like, oh, it felt like a full day passed, and then it started again.
I've heard London speak about it more in terms of the context of who he is as an artist. So how they experienced and incorporated moving forward, I think will probably be unique to themselves. It sounds like Rob is a student, right?
Matter. And those matters behave with each other in certain ways. And that, students, is chemistry. Everything in this world.
Give me some 70s. Done with this 30 and 40 degree stuff.
I mean, I knew of like Wim Hof, like the Iceman, you know, would like climb Mount Everest in like bare feet and get a t-shirt or something like that. Pretty cool. Didn't really know how that would impact my life at all if I were to try it.
From my understanding, the Wim Hof Method was a technique developed from a man who climbed a mountain facing harsh weather. And through that trial and tribulation, he started to realize that if you have controlled breathing in combination with the cold weather, you can have your body adapt to such environment. And then because of that, then he started to create a sort of training that can be kind of like distributed that other people can practice too. But yeah, I think he got it through a serendipitous self-discovery.
Water, elixir of life.
Find at the bottom of that barrel is love. That's what we're releasing, that's what we spread to each other, that's how you build strong community.
You know, I'm sure there'll be some questions, or if you just want to like sit in the space, like, you know, that kind of thing. But yeah, that'd be cool. Because I could listen, man, I could talk forever on this shit. I love it so much. So yeah, it'd be cool to experience it.
Yep.
So these workshops you're having, you said they're 2 hours long?
4 hours, yeah.
4 hours.
I like to go over a few different things. One, the biology of the body, just how, you know, how the body works, physiology of the body, and then how the breath and the cold can adjust, or not adjust, but they can affect, you know, our systems, like, what is the benefit of that, you know? So
there's three parts of the Wim Hof Method. So which one are we going to take on first?
From a conceptual standpoint, what is happening physiologically is really powerful. So I like to go over those different elements and then go into each individual modality that, you know, the method consists of, which is the breath, mindset training, and then ultimately an ice bath.
Yeah, Mike. So I get that there's breathing, and there's a breath hold and stuff, but what's different about how I'm supposed to breathe mm-hmm. with this method in particular?
Specifically with the Wim Hof method of breath, people feel that they have to go really fast, and that's not the case at all. You know, so you'll get people that are novice, you know, breathwork practitioners that will be hyperventilating out of control. And the whole thing with the Wim Hof method, whether you're breathing like in through your nose, out through your mouth, a simple, or if you're, you know, getting at it, like, you always want to be in control of the breath.
So like, we kind of connected on like just being the same name. Like any Michael will tell you, it's like you meet another Michael, it's like, oh, we know each other. We're boys. So I met him, cool dude. And then a week later, I see that video. The week after, I go to catering and he's just standing there talking about it. I was like, dude, what? I mean, as soon as you have an instructor or someone who knows what they're doing teach you breathwork, you completely shift and understand like, whoa, here's this thing that I've been surrounded by my entire life that I need oxygen to be alive, and I haven't thought about it once. Never thought about it.
keep in mind with the Wim Hof method, it's like going to the gym for your breath. You're stressing, you know, your system. Willingly, it's a hormesis. It's like going to the gym. When you go to the gym, you're stressing your muscles, you're ripping your muscles. But that short-term stress equals a long-term strength. I'll give you an example. Say this is like a 20-pound, you know, weight, right? It'd be the smallest 20-pound weight there is, right? But okay, so say you're just doing bicep curls. You're stressing, you're relaxing. You're stressing, you're relaxing. You're stressing, you're relaxing. You're ripping your muscle. You're tearing your muscle, right? Then you give it that opportunity to heal, and this will become stronger than it was before.
Look at me, I'm like a degenerate who also wants to be a better person.
For all my anime fans out there, if you watch this show, you would know all the characters from this show is all about deep breathing and how they can get these superpowers from just deep breathing and meditative breathing. So for all the weebs out there, you know about this character. You know about Zenitsu, and you know about Tanjiro, how they use the Wim Hof method to pull out their katanas and kill demons.
Hi guys, welcome. This is a guided breathing session. Lie down, sit down, whatever it takes, relax. Are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
Here we go. Round number one. Breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. Let it go. Round number three. Back into that rhythm. Breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. In with the relaxation, distress. In, out. In, out.
So I had a lot of like profound thoughts during that. It was kind of like, let me get some meditation done while I'm at it. I noticed when I had my hands on my hips like this, then I did that on the third round, and I was like, okay, why did I do this naturally? And I realized, I think when I'm naturally uncomfortable or like I want to seek warmth, so your body will always look for the warmest thing. So I grabbed my hips to feel like a sense of comfort when I was like being challenged a little more. So I think that was just like a funny like epiphany I had. I'm like, do all of us only look for comfortable situations and comfortable feelings?
So I'm Yvonne Wells. I'm associate professor at Suffolk University in Boston. I was looking at the Wim Hof method and the man, I believe he was from Holland or from the North countries, who it looks as if just accidentally, by his nature, got involved in exposing himself to extreme cold and became the object of researchers.
One of the things that was really powerful for me about this method in particular, and Wim in particular, is he wanted to go to scientists, to universities, to get this stuff documented, to get tested with all of the experiments that they were doing so they would have actual knowledge down to a cellular level, what the biology was, what the effects were telling us about, you know, how the body works and how these methods and tools can really optimize us.
If this method, we're looking at the Wim Hof method, begins to give people another tool to stop that, you know, like I think young people say, I'm getting a cold, and I see their spirit just, you know, I'm just, and then they just have the flu for weeks. So what if you said, nope, this inflammation's gotta be leaving, and you're constantly working in on these methods?
I'd love to get into more like the science of it too, and like try and understand exactly like what he's controlling, you know, if he's exactly where is that control coming from.
So inflammation, essentially, chronic inflammation is what we're trying to mitigate. 80% of all disease, pathogen, whatever, it's chronic inflammation. We can mitigate that just with the way that we breathe.
Would I do it? Yeah, I guess. It just sounds like taking a meditation class. Yeah. It's okay to sit like this?
Just be here for a moment before we get into some Wim Hof breathing. And just witness. Check in. With the breath now, we are going to inhale fully through the nose, exhale gently out of the mouth. We are purposely exhaling out of the mouth for this exercise. Inhale fully through the nose. Exhale gently out of the mouth. Just let it go. And repeat. Inhale through the nose. Exhale out of the mouth. Release. And continue. Inhale through the nose. Exhale gently out of the mouth. Beautiful. Continue with this breath. We're going to do this for 30 times. I'll keep track of all the counting. Just focus on breathing in through the nose, into the diaphragm, gently out of the mouth. Inhale fully, gently. Exhale, gently. Release. Inhale and exhale. Very nice. As we get deep into this kind of breathing, we alkalize the blood. We lessen inflammation in the blood. We lessen carbon dioxide while increasing oxygen. You might feel a response. Hands tingle, feet tingle. It's all good. Exhale, and last one. Inhale fully all the way. Fill up, fill up, fill up, fill up. Exhale gently. Let it go and hold the breath at the bottom. Hold the breath at the bottom of the exhale and just be, just witness. Once we get past that 10 seconds, feel your body sink into that stillness and just be. Three, two, one. Full inhalation all the way in. And hold the breath at the top. Three, two, one. Exhale, let it go. Take a moment and just witness.
I have some pretty strong lungs. It felt nice. Yep. It was like a little bit harder because in swimming, you learning that, hold it in and then breathe out through your mouth and nose, and you got the bubbles. I didn't have the bubbles. So it was hard to know when I was done breathing out. So it's some work, but it's really nice. And it seems like something someone who was injured in a wheelchair, everybody can do it. Yeah.
We already had the origin, the guy who tried it on his own and started to build off of it, and now everybody else has their hands on it, trying to practice and add to the conversation or discovery of this breathing method. So I think we're at that next step.
That's a huge thing too. He didn't like the term the Wim Hof method, because he's like, well, what happens when I die? Like, what's gonna transform? How's that? Like, it's not my thing. This is, you know, that kind of thing.
There's no need to replicate what he did already, and because that moment already happened in time. Yeah.
Is that the dude from Get Him to the Greek?
You know what I'm talking about?
Hi guys, welcome. This is a guided breathing session. Relax to the deepest. Lie down, sit down, whatever it takes, relax. Are you ready? Here we go. Round number one. Breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. Just go with the flow of the breath. In, out. In, out. In, out. In, out. Into the belly, into the chest, and let go. Like a wave. 5 more. Let's give it all we got. Last one. Pull here and let go. All right. 1 minute breath hold from now on. Be in this moment. Pause the video now and continue when you feel the urge to breathe. Okay. Recovery breath in. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Take a deep breath in and hold for 15 seconds. Exhale in 3, 2, 1. Let it go. Round number 2. Back into that rhythm. Breathe in, breathe out, breathe in.
Crazy. It said, like, hold your breath for a minute and a half. And I was like, there's no way I can do this. And it felt really nerve-wracking, kind of. Like, I felt like a tension in my chest. And then I was getting down to, like, 20 seconds, 30 seconds or something. And I was like, oh, wow, this is actually pretty easy. Then it hits zero. I'm like, I can keep going.
We're gonna do a 4-6 count breath right here. I'll keep track of the counting. What a 4-6 breath is we inhale slowly for 4 seconds in through the nose, and we exhale slowly for 6 seconds out of the nose. Now, when we inhale first, we're gonna inhale starting low in the diaphragm. If you all, you can bring your hands underneath your ribs and just feel, poke in with your fingers underneath your rib cage.
I started when I met Mike. I didn't know who Wim Hof was, and I had no breath work practice at all. But whenever we would hang out, Mike would just start breathing. Like, he'd ask if I want to join, and he would just start breathing. I was like, this person really does not give a shit. Like, he'll just, like, we'll be on the subway, we'll be at the beach, and you'll just start breathing.
At the time, I was a public school teacher, so it made a huge impact on my work day when I primed myself just by incorporating the practice in the morning before the kids came in. I found myself more ready to engage, kind of like more curious, more playful, less stressed. So that's how I came through the Wim Hof Method through Mike, who's now teaching it. And so we do that from our house now.
In a weird way, say what you will about it, but everyone learned about this on the internet. In the end of the day, we're all geeks. I mean, I'm a victim of it too. Like, I like my fighting games. We all find something on the internet, we get fascinated with it, and then we find other people on the internet to kind of believe in it too. When one person kind of understands it, and then that becomes something positive for him, and then he finds other people who kind of echo him and enjoy the same thing. And then they start finding other people that kind of like create, I don't want to say, but like a cult. Yeah, I'm super like dreading being in an uncomfortable situation.
So you just gotta try it, man. You just gotta try it.
I would just say to anyone that's a skeptic, whether it's a doctor or someone on the street, just come on, let's do it. Let's go breathe and get in the ice.
Also, part of my personality is that I welcome kind of like these different situations. If I'm always comfortable in my everyday approach, am I making things challenging? Probably not. I think this is like creating a voluntary challenge for myself.
Hey guys. Let's do this, I guess. It's chilly. Yeah. Probably about 1 hour away. Where are we actually right now?
North Adams.
North Adams. That's still Massachusetts?
Yeah.
Okay, so we haven't hit New York yet. He's a true New Englander. Probably cuts his own wood.
Oh. Hey, how are you? London.
So, Michael. Pleasure.
Welcome. Nice to meet you. Thanks for having me.
Oh, our pleasure, man. Thanks for coming.
Yeah.
Excited you're here. Experience this.
First time.
Yeah.
Coming in right blind.
On. I love it.
Yeah.
It's kind of like what Bruce Lee said, you know, just learn as much as you can and then get rid of the fat. He said it more eloquently.
Yeah, he was a philosopher, like to the fullest in terms of like egoless optimization.
Yeah.
You know, it's not like, oh, I don't know that thing, I'm bad, whatever. It's like, oh, I don't know that, I want to learn that thing. It's going to help me improve.
That's a good term. Egoless optimization.
So we're going to start some Wim Hof breathing here. Nice and slow at first. Inhale through the nose, exhale through the mouth. Great. Inhale and exhale. That's it. Perfect. Beautiful. Relaxing. Torso fills fully in. Allow the breath, the inhalation, to move your body. Allow the exhalation just to relax it. Inhale. Let it go out. 25 more of these. I'll keep track of the counting. Excellent. And continue. Fully in. Exhale, release, let it go. Hold the breath at the bottom and just be, just witness with the breath held. Feel the body. It's full of oxygen. We don't need air. CO2 levels are down. Allow yourself to sit in that stillness and just witness. With your breath held at the top, fully relax your body in a way that you can internally feel your spine expand from that internal pressure build. 3, 2, 1, exhale, let it go. Just be for a moment, just observe. I'm gonna blanket. And now let's move that same attention and awareness to our hands. As a breakdancer, you're on your hands a lot. You demand a lot from them. On this next inhalation, allow a breath of gratitude in for your hands. Thank your hands. And on the exhale, release any tension that's felt in them. Take your time. I'm gonna stoke the fire a little bit. On your count, slowly start to come back.
That's a lot of thoughts. But no thoughts at the same time.
What were you feeling beforehand? What are you feeling afterwards? Like your calmness level, your thought patterns, that kind of thing.
Generally, I don't feel like I'm a nervous person by nature, but I do notice that I have more less noise in my head now. So it's like I'm not actively like protesting whatever's going in my head. I'm just like allowing my thoughts to actually, in a way, weird way, my thoughts have their own breathing pattern instead of trying to put them all together at once. Usually I would compete with myself trying to organize what I thought about during the day. I would have to journal that. But yeah, so in short, it definitely has a positive effect on my mental thinking and health as I exit from the meditation.
That's one of the things that I find too that helps me a lot is there's less judgment towards the thoughts themselves.
No more than, I don't get cult vibes from Wim Hof any more than I get cult vibes from if a group of women from my church say, we're going to do a silent retreat. Am I in a cult there?
I don't know where the biases come from, but I can understand when anybody sees a group of people doing something together, they just get an automatic alarm. It's like, oh, I didn't know there was a group of people doing this. So therefore, they're automatically cult.
I'll be honest. To me, I think it's Wim.
Yeah.
Like, not a purposeful thing, but Wim is so charismatic, and he's such... Wim is like the realest of the deals out of all the real deals there is. You know what I mean? So, like, when you get somebody like that, that is that charismatic, like, it's naturally going to form an allegiance of people that want to follow.
So it could happen to any group of people, but when you get into the group or follow the charismatic leader, you too have to follow for a purpose and do something with it. And this right here is not saying get together and all obey some person.
When I first like started this, Wim was like, this isn't a cult. Like that was one of the first things he said, this is not a cult, okay? You know, that kind of thing, but. Yeah. That was in the first times I ever met him. He did that to someone. They're like, yeah, we're the guru. He's like, I'm not a guru, man. F*** you. You're the guru, man. But that's, you know what I mean? That I think it's because there's such an enigmatic leader.
And as we lay here, we catapult ourselves to a nice warm beach. As we feel the sand below us that we lay on. And as we're close to the water's edge, we start to feel a nice, warm, gentle wave come up over our feet and our ankles. And as it goes back out to sea, it brings with any stress, any strain left over, any tension we have. We release it. And as that wave comes back up to shore, goes over our lower legs, our calves, our shins, our knees. And as it goes back out to the sea, it brings with it any stress, any strain, any tension we have. As we feel it come up over the tops of our legs, our quads, our hamstrings, our hip flexors, our glutes, we allow that tension to be released. Back out up to sea.
So like the first thing is to say in the Wim Hof Method kind of engages like a stress response. But then it says, in addition, the Wim Hof Method also engages higher order cortical areas, left anterior and right middle insula,
that are uniquely associated with self-reflection, which facilitate both internal focus and sustained attention in the presence of adverse external stimuli, like the cold.
You're like putting your body under stress and like kind of teaching your body, I feel like, to calm itself down during that stressful situation of holding your breath.
Pretty interesting stuff.
Yeah, it's just like the most interesting thing I've really done, Benny. It's funny that I feel like I didn't realize how high up we are.
This is where we strengthen the nervous system. That stress response. To where external stresses don't affect us as much because we can breathe and focus in this environment right here.
When you get into a stressful environment, things take your exhales away. When you get scared, when you get cold, what we want to do, allow that exhale to flow. The more you can let that exhale flow, the calmer your system, the warmer you'll be. So while we're getting into a stressful situation, an environment right here that's cold, we can regulate the body to warm up. And we just flow. See if you can push with one hand while you pull with the other.
I'm gonna save you guys later when you get out and you start shivering, you're gonna get right back into this and create that inner fire.
Are you breathing out through your mouth now?
You can. You can, try and just nose as much as you can.
Okay.
But if you need to, in through the nose, out through the mouth.
Nice and slowly. When you're ready, we'll start to come down. Double check for your cell phones.
Thank you, very nice.
Walk in up to your waist. Notice how the water gets higher, the breath gets shorter. So we walk up to our waist.
Woo!
So one, two, three, down up to your shoulders.
Exhale when you go down.
Very nice. So just witness the feeling and calmly breathe. Excellent job. Excellent job. Great job. Feel that sun. It's life-giving. Warmth-giving. Excellent. Let's do some sun salutes, some salutations. Inhale up. Push the palms together as you exhale down. In a prayer squat. Inhale up.
Very nice. A couple more minutes here, and then we give a sun salute. With the movement and the
I don't know if skeptical is the right word. Definitely just, I don't understand exactly what is going on, and I'd like to understand. I'm not skeptical of, like, the impacts of it or the data that they've gotten from it, but definitely, like, I'd like to know more, and it's something I don't understand a lot about, and I don't think that many people do understand, like, really the root of what he's changing. But, like, there definitely seems to be something changing.
We are doing breathing session number 5. It's an ice bath upstairs after this.
35. 36-ish.
some movements after.
Hi guys, welcome. This is a guided breathing session. Relax to the deepest. Lie down, sit down, whatever it takes, relax. Are you ready? Here we go. Round number one. Breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. Just go with the flow of the breath. In, out, in, out, into the belly, into the chest, and let go, like a wave. Make it circular. Ulie, and let go. All right, 1 minute, breath hold from now on. Be in this.
In my own words, okay. Yeah, so it's kind of like breathing pretty heavy rhythmically for a short period of time, really kind of getting all the oxygen into you, as much oxygen as you can in your blood, getting all the carbon dioxide out. You'll hold your breath, which really allows you to kind of like relax to the fullest extent. Like, and they say in the video, like, try and control your heartbeat. And you can like kind of like indirectly control your heartbeat, and it's kind of a weird feeling when you really feel that, like you like listen for, I usually try and like listen to the space between my heartbeats, and like even kind of when you're putting yourself under that like apoxic low oxygen stress, you can still you're still relaxing and you can kind of, there's a like an emptiness feeling and a very quietness that you can really feel within your body.
If I were to take all of your capillaries, veins, line them up end to end, you would die. Brutal, right? Good joke? In all honesty, if I were to take all the capillaries, blood vessels, and veins out of your body and line them up end to end, it would circle the globe almost 3 times. Inside one human body. Now, most of those capillaries and blood vessels, the reason why you feel it in your hands and your feet more is that's where the majority of them are. So the reason why you're feeling that pain in your hands is because that vasoconstriction, the capillaries closing and opening, creates that sensation. So what we do, that's the work. Just allow them to flow, breathe into them, give them some flexing. Flexing creates that energy, that heat. And you'll notice in a couple minutes, it will be gone.
And if you want to grab your towel and just kind of towel off, the water's pulling the heat out of you.
The last, like, 30 seconds were pretty tough. The last like 30 seconds were like, then my brain was like, all right, you gotta get out of here, get out of here. But yeah, it kind of like feels the same still. It's just like your brain's telling you to leave. It's kind of hard to explain in words. It's very much of a feeling thing, but I don't know, if you kind of just like relax and let it go, it's really not that bad.
Or else I sing, swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home. And bust about that time, you're almost at 3 minutes.
He's like, yeah, warm you.
The more in power you feel, the more you're going to activate that. Right. And then the more you're going to spread that, and people feel that, you know. But the energy of the group, it's palpable. You feel it.
So this is us, even in our times of going through our own shit, we pick up other people's. That's good stuff. Right on. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Now we just leave it there, right?
That's it. Yeah, let's go.
All right, let's go.
For us, they're like, yeah, this will keep the house
clean. There was a moment. Yeah, everybody started freaking out in the beginning. Like, oh shit, this is really, really cold. And then all of a sudden, like, everything got quiet and everybody was like finding their peace. Oh, okay.
Once we were opening up here.
Yeah.
I remember when we were up to the waist. And he said, okay, then, you know, at the count of three, you're going to go down. And I was just like, are we? Really?
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Kind of in there for like a while at that point. And he was like,
All right, now everyone's gonna slowly. I thought he was gonna say we're gonna slowly rise, and he's like, we're gonna slowly breathe. We got like 30 seconds.
When he said 30 seconds, I was like, it can't be so much longer. I can't be in here any longer. But yeah.
From the Goonies.
Hey, you guys! Hey, you guys! Hey, you guys!
That's funny.
Premium ice is a as opposed to that cheap ice. This is premium.
One of the things why the ice and the breath are so cool, you see people, you see them. You can't, you're not gonna fucking lie in an ice bath. You good luck lying and like trying to pretend about things. Like, you're there and you gotta just be there and that's it. And you see people in that. You see how they breathe. You see that fight until that relaxation. Like, you see those things, you know what I mean? So it's a very visceral thing that you're having this communion with somebody.
Yeah, I could see working up to being able to tolerate. I don't see the point of going to a gathering of people and going in a cryo. I don't see myself doing that, but I definitely see this idea of conditioning to deal as our ancestors did in the cold or outside. Yeah.
But anyways, fast forward, when I was like a kid in like third grade, I remember my parent, we couldn't afford like all the most clothes and jackets to go to school, and I'd be like sitting outside, walking in school without a coat.
Yeah.
Man, so yeah, I mean, you had the real deal. This is purposeful.
Like,
this
survive,
is
walk into the cold.
This is a cakewalk.
Two days ago, it was like sunny.
20 minutes ago, it was sunny.
We've arrived at the lake. Here are my teachers, my facilitators. In all honesty, I think I'm ready. I'm not too worried about it. I got this. I hyped myself up already. I'm ready.
Easy breezy. The water's gonna wanna take your breath away. It's gonna wanna, okay, that's fine. Whatever you have to do for that 20, 30 seconds to, we're gonna do. So even if you get in and it's like, wow, now look at this.
Right? We got all seasons in like 10 minutes.
The weather changed. It's springtime in the mountains.
Wow. Stunning. And it's still coming because it's coming from this way. It's going like northeast.
Has anyone ever tried going it backwards opposed to forward?
Ooh, no.
That could be you.
That can be you.
Psychologically not psych them out.
No, but that can be you. You can kind of like... do the Jesus.
Do the Jesus. I think I'll try that.
Kathy has a theory that Jesus and John the Baptist were just doing ice baths.
Good theory.
That's all the baptism was.
Okay, I'm ready.
Do you want to go in backwards? You want to go in forwards?
Bye.
And just notice your breath. As you go further in.
Oh, it's cold.
Even now, start to focus in on the exhales. There you go. Good breath right there. Very nice.
Is here good?
If that's good for you, if you feel you can get down to your shoulders, exhale on the way down when you go. Very nice. And you can just sit. Just sit down. Yeah. Excellent job, London. Great job, dude. Your breath will become calmer and it will adjust. So just allow whatever needs to be done right now with the breath to get you into those exhales. Thank you.
Oh, I'm gonna move. This table's one of my gosh, you can't even see me. What a riot. Yeah, I want some. Oh, will you send it to me?
Yeah.
Inhale up, exhale down. Full inhale, let it go. Yeah, so let yourself sink in all the way to your shoulders. Yeah, and now just adjust the breath. Yeah, and you let it flow out. There you go, you elongate those exhales. Beautiful.
You always have to like breathe downwards.
Yeah, absolutely. Because everything stays high. That's what stress does. It keeps the breath high. Breathe into that diaphragm. Breathe into the intercostals. And elongate the exhale. Great job. That was a good breath right there. You'll feel your body adjust. So now that the body's adjusted, without moving your body, release the fight from your shoulders. Release that tension. Just exhale it away. Good. Couple more breaths just like that. Release that tension. Beautiful. Because this is the thing, we don't have to fight it. The power's within. A couple
I went
seconds.
Lower 'cause I was acting. Yeah. My body was, things that were tense were keeping me up.
Yeah. Good little metaphor. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I mean, it was like literally too.
Yeah.
Yeah. It was like my feet were tense, so they were, my body was
nice. Top hand push, bottom hand pull. Yeah, very nice. Great job. Allow that breath. Very nice. Inhale up. Palms push together as you exhale nice and gently down. Inhale up. Palms together. Exhale down. Great stuff.
Yeah,
good stuff.
All right. Woo! Yep, about a 45-minute hike. Some people trying some cold stuff, some people not. Feeling is knowing. You gotta try it out for yourself. Off we go. Look at these little ones.
During the fall, the leaves are just the most vibrant colors of red and orange and yellow and the green that's underneath too. And really looking forward to spring. We haven't been here for the spring, so this will be, yeah, we're really excited about it.
So don't think that you need to go like, you don't have to go at that pace. That's, you can build to that pace, but just like half that time, like.
Internally, feel your pulse on the inside of your left ankle.
We are mammals. The hair on our chest and between our legs reminds us so. We try hard to deny our unrefined animalistic nature. Yet through this archetype, we tap into power and direction. Activating the animal within means reawakening our relationship to nature in the most broad and embodied sense. If this all sounds terribly unsophisticated to you, take note that it is said that when Buddha became enlightened, he roared like a lion.
to get on that collective consciousness, that collective frequency, we turbocharge each other.